Hello, everyone. This is Sylvain from Gatineau. Welcome to my Sundays at 6, a weekly video message of discussion-starting ideas. And here's a brief list of this week's ideas to consider and discuss if you're an employer affected by the global crown virus crisis. And as you listen to my list, please remember that when things change, especially a global scale change like this one, there are new holes to fill for entrepreneurs who see change as an opportunity. Hopefully that means you and I. And by the way, my more comprehensive list of ideas will be shared with you in a future video. Here we go with idea number one. Idea number one, the great deal. Offer your past customers right now a great deal that you normally wouldn't offer them. Create this great deal offer, then send it to them in an email campaign. This will help maintain your relationships with them so they don't start drifting away from you. Check out your competition online. They're probably offering a great deal right now, or they might be doing something else that you should be trying. So check them out. You have plenty of time. Or hire somebody to do it. Next, educational podcasts. This is another simple way to maintain your client relationships. Make a podcast to teach your customers useful things. They will remember you as an expert in your field. Use Skype, FaceTime, Zoom, phone, text, any way you want. Some of them may even pay you for your online consulting services during the crisis when they see your video. You might trigger some ideas in their mind. So many people that I know are offering consulting services online, for instance, using Skype. Some of them have been using that method before. It does work. Okay, next. I'm not saying necessarily with Skype, but with tools like Skype where the two of you can see each other. Okay, perhaps Zoom might be better. Maybe the professional version of Zoom. Next, focus on essentials. Provide an essential service to essential businesses and organizations. Essential organizations are those that are permitted by law to operate by law during the crisis. Such organizations also have, at this time, an increased need for services, products, and people that you can perhaps provide. Check it out. Or you may know somebody who can provide those services for these essential organizations and businesses. Next, compensation options. In slow economic times, it becomes important to keep maintaining your edge even when your revenue resources are drying up or they have almost dried up. Keep your ideas, your interests, your energy, your passion for what you're doing flowing and not stagnating. Till that time where the markets return to normal. You also need to keep your best workers from drifting and departing. A temporary way to keep them is through email IOUs. Email IOUs are as good as cash when, you know, with people you trust. So an email agreement, I believe, is also as legally binding as one that is faxed, and perhaps it's as good as cash. Something to consider. Barter is another option to consider. And you can also consider having key workers sponsored by another party, a third party. Some people still have loads of money and they don't know what to do with it because many of them are pulling their investments, their stocks, away from the stock market now, as you know. So they want to invest in something useful. And so some of them are generous and would gladly support or invest in essential service providers, so you can become one. If you can provide an essential service using your essential staff to essential organizations, it's easier to get a sponsor for a worker or two, as well as for clients, okay? Anyways, everyone's benefits in a worker-sponsored program, even the government can benefit as well also. Next, anticipated hires. If you're an employer and you had to lay off your staff because of the crisis, then you might want to consider adding to your website a list of job descriptions for anticipated job openings once the pandemic is over, you know, in your career section. The job descriptions should be adapted to the new market realities, and so you can hit the ground running once the world is open for business again. And by the way, you may want to email a link to this anticipated openings page, or career page, in your website to some of your former employees. Restaffing may not be easy when people move on, retire, or start their own business. We don't know how long this crisis will last. It's good to be prepared for any eventuality. Next is communication. Communication is key to the success of any company, any family even. We often miss out on opportunities when we don't listen to our markets, our staff, or even our friends. My weekly Zoom meetings use a simple new way of group communication that I have created, one that encourages us all to speak clearly, briefly, and usefully, and also to listen to others more profitably. Let me tell you a brief story about the monetary value of communication. It's very real. I once worked for a huge manufacturer as a lab technician in their research department. Because I improved the communications within the company by suggesting we had a special meeting, I soon became director of research within a few months of me being hired. The story is, I won't go into the details. Here's the bottom line. As a lab technician, I did what I was told to do. And one day, the president called his research, we had two research divisions. One was long-term projects and the other was short-term projects. And everybody was there except the secretary. She called in sick, and they called me into their meeting to see if I could take notes. And so I did. I took notes, but to my surprise, I was ready for this, but to my surprise, as the meeting was going on, well, the president asked for a status report from each person, and then he looked at me and he said, "Well, Sylvain, do you have anything to say about our projects?" Well, I said, "Yes, I do. I have two things. One, as a lab technician, I'm being told what to do, but I'm not being told what the goal of the project is. I'd like to know what the goal of the project was." And he got so upset when he heard that. So he asked my bosses, "So what is the project that we're working on right now? What are the details?" And anyways, I don't want to talk about the reaction. It was so funny. So he said, Sylvain, he said, "Well, okay, you're going to clarify the mission, objective, the vision. And also, what's your second suggestion?" And that's what really helped me in the company climb. I suggested, "Chief, you've been working on this project, this particular project, for almost 30 years, and we don't have a product yet. May I make a recommendation as to how we can possibly have a product quicker?" He said, "Yeah, go ahead." I said, "I would like to recommend that we make a meeting and invite all the people who ever worked on that project, including those who are retired, et cetera, et cetera, to the meeting. And I would like to decide who goes to the meeting." Well, he said, "Well, providing everybody has a security clearance, organize it." And so I organized it. And at this meeting, I invited, of course, all my superiors, people with PhD degrees. I only have a bachelor's. And I made a recommendation that we also invite the janitor. And why the janitor? Because he was the person responsible for putting away all the samples that were coming to us from different chemical companies around the world, and keeping a list of all the material safety data sheets and so on. But he was also able to attend the presentations of the representatives of these international companies. And somehow I asked him, I invited him to come. He says, "Oh, sure." He said, "I'll come." So at the meeting, I made it very simple. I said, "Okay, everybody, we're each going to have an opportunity to say how we can solve this research objective." And so we went around the table, and the first few engineers that spoke and chemists that spoke, they were laughing. They're saying, "Hey, we can never solve this. This is impossible." And I responded, "Perhaps you're right, but we're paid to solve it, and right now we have a job trying to solve it." So some engineers refused to comment. So I went on to the next ones, and some PhDs gave some theoretical explanation how it could be solved, and so on. But then, as we did the second time, second turn around, because I made two turns of it, because sometimes an idea makes other idea come to mind. So, in the second turn around, at that point, the janitor came in and sat down. I invited him to sit down, and I told him why he was here. And I also asked him, "How do you think we can solve this problem?" Well, he said, "A few years ago, a guy from a European chemical company came by and suggested a product. And in my mind, the way he explained it, it would work for the project." And as he said that, one of the PhDs there asked, "Well, what was the name of the product?" And he said it. And anyways, to make a long story short, we got a sample of that product again, and it was the solution. And the janitor found the solution, and he got a promotion too in the company. And our product was made. So, the value of communication with everybody. Next, transportation. Public buses are now free and empty in my city. Perhaps it's the same thing in your city. They provide a good way to get around and save money. Private bus companies, you should keep them in mind. They're also an interesting option at this time because they are currently very affordable and they allow you to get around anywhere you want door to door. The advantage of using a private bus company is that since many meeting places like restaurants, cafes are now closed, you can rent a minibus, a limousine, or even a motor coach affordably and use the vehicle as the meeting place itself while you tour around a quiet, empty city in all privacy and comfort. Air conditioned, TVs, even washroom. Okay, so private bus companies sanitize their vehicles also every single trip and have good air conditioning. Next, intrapreneurship. Invite your staff to start a business within your business, regardless of what it is. Experiment with new business areas through your staff because some of them may be very well connected to crisis market opportunities you're not even aware of. In this crisis, people need food, healing, entertainment, education, and consulting. Perhaps one of your staff intrapreneurs will show you new ways to cut your operational costs. Another can introduce you to smart marketing, crisis marketing, content marketing, and so on. Be adaptable. When it rains, sell raincoats and umbrellas. When it's sunny, sell hats. When people are hungry, grow food. When there's a virus running around, then disinfect your homes, your offices, and your vehicles. Big market for that. There's a super demand for cleaners and cleaning companies and cleaning equipment and cleaning technology, etc. When your kids are bored, show them how to make Lego pieces with a new waffle iron so that they can finally play with their food and build their own castles on their plates. So in a time of quarantine, sell quarantine kits. When change happens, have new needs. People have new needs. Are you doing all of the things that you need to be doing to keep your business alive? Keep in mind that the major changes taking place in humanity worldwide right now could become permanent. And so this is no time for vacation. Working from home offices could be a permanent change. Takeout and delivery services could become another permanent change. At times like this, we shouldn't just offer technology solutions So email your staff and ask them for ideas, then invest in them, if you can, somehow. Sometimes spin-offs are more profitable than their mother companies. Next, crisis committees. Use Zoom.com and use it to organize committee meetings of like-minded people that will exchange ideas and support each other in the group, including you. If your committee is successful, then it may even continue meeting way beyond the crisis period. Start with a committee of friends, and once your meetings are productive enough, then start a committee with partners, suppliers, clients, even bankers, and potential investors. Always add value to your meetings so your committee meetings become everyone's favorite meeting. They'll come back. Crisis committee can attract idea, resources, people, and capital. My second to last suggestion, portability. Make products that are more portable. Even the packaging of your products can become smarter and more useful to your clients. The takeout and delivery business is booming right now, not only for food and medicine. Takeout and delivery may become a permanent change, as I said before, in our society, affecting many different established industries. Finally, my weird idea of the week, the Green Lantern idea. In my whole life, there are two houses that I remember very vividly in my mind. I remember how they look, where they are, and how to get there. Both have two things in common: a green light in the front porch, and very expensive cars parked in their driveways. As I walked by these houses a long time ago, many years ago, I always wondered why they had a green light. I still don't know. But what matters is that I remember these houses. So do their neighbors. So do all those people passing by year after year. Everybody remembers those two houses. And here's my last idea today concerning mindshare. Try leaving green lights on at night at your home or business, if the lights can be seen from outside. You'll stand out from all the other lights, white lights in your city. At a time like this, we need to try everything we can to make us stand out and be remembered. At the price of a green light bulb, this may be my least expensive idea, but it could lead to others and become one of the more profitable ones. Well, at least it'll get people talking. Perhaps the Green Lantern idea might become a sign of the creative and willful spirit to survive and thrive during using our imagination during these difficult times. Who knows? Anyways, that's it for this week's broadcast. I hope you'll tune in same time next week for more ideas to consider and discuss. Use the comments below to share any idea you'd like others to consider and discuss as well. And so basically start something now that will continue to be in demand long after this crisis is over. And that's